Eyewitness News at 10's Ryan Hughes is live at UCF tonight, and Ryan, students there are remembering Sotloff.
Nancy, he went to classes here at the School of Communication for 2 years, so students can certainly relate to his fond passion for journalism. Tonight, they mourn his untimely death in such a barbaric way. Those who knew Stephen Sotloff clung to hope 2 weeks ago, thinking the former University of Central Florida student might be released by a militant group in the Middle East. That hope is now in shambles upon word of the death of Sotloff, reportedly headed by the group ISIS.
We all have heavy hearts here on this campus.
UCF Student Government Association Vice President Sydney Altfield spoke on behalf of the student body.
Everyone that comes here is a knight and always a knight, and I know that his legacy will definitely be left on this campus.
Sotloff went to UCF from 2002 to 2004 and studied journalism. His passion for the news inspired him to travel to danger zones overseas. Last year, while reporting in Syria, Sotloff was kidnapped by ISIS and held until his death this week.
Our knife will continue to strike the necks of your people.
Tonight I spoke to Florida Congressman Alan Grayson by phone.
I'm disgusted and horrified like almost everybody else.
Grayson told me it's not the duty of the U.S. to attack ISIS just yet. He wants nearby countries to fight back first.
What I'm still hoping to see, though, is local Muslim countries in the area take responsibility for putting down the ISIS uprising.
Last week, Sotloff's mother appealed for her son's safe release. Tonight, the family is in mourning in South Florida, requesting privacy as they remember their loved one taken by such brutal hands. Now, I reached out to other members of Florida's congressional delegation, but they either weren't in town or simply didn't have comment for the story. We're told the vigil is scheduled here on campus for 9 tomorrow night. Live at UCF in Orange County, Ryan Hughes, Eyewitness News at 10.